We're ready for you, Lan Nhi.
Today I would like to tell you the second story, John Thornton. John Thornton had saved Buzz's life, but further, he was perfect master. Other men look after their dogs because they thought it was their duty, and because it was good for their business, John Thornton looked after his dog. Gave they were his own children because he couldn't have it, and he saw further. He never forgot to kind word and to sit down for a long talk with them. Was his delight as much as theirs? He had a way of talking birds, held roughly between his hands, and writing his own. As often buzz, he would say buzz back and forth, all the time calling him buzz names. With the buzz was love names, buzz knew no greater joy than his mother's rough address and name calling. As it pulled back and forth, it seemed that his heart would be taken out of his body. But his joy was so great, and when John Thornton let him go, Buzz sprang to his face. His mouth laughed, his eyes sparkled, and his throat vibrated with unspoken sound. It thus Mandelberg remained without moving, so that John Thornton couldn't cry, "God, you can almost speak."